Hairstyling is an important, foundational skill that allows the professional to articulate creativity and deliver a specific outcome desired by the client. Our learning objective for this lesson is to be able to execute finger waving and pin curling. The client consultation is always the first step in the hairstyling process. When deciding the best hairstyle for your client, you should have them look through magazines or Google photos of styles that she likes. Have a portfolio of work that you have performed to share with your clients that displays your skills. Many times, you will be called upon as a stylist to help your client solve hair problems. Some clients may not like their hairstyle because it may not be as flattering on them as they anticipated it to be. It is your job to help the client choose a style that will work for them based on their face shape, hair type, and lifestyle. Hairstyling is the temporary, physical change in the wave pattern of the hair. A temporary change means the hair will go back to its original wave pattern once it has been shampooed. A physical change means the hair has not been chemically altered and only impacts the hydrogen and salt bonds in the cortex layer of the hair shaft. Hairstyling is the foundation for all hairdressing. There are two types of hairstyling, wet and dry hairstyling. Finger waving, pin curls, and roller sets are all examples of wet hairstyling, as they are performed on hair that is wet and has been prepared with styling lotions or products that help to reform the hair's natural wave pattern. Blow drying, curling or flat ironing, and hair pressing are all examples of dry hairstyling and are processes that are performed on dry hair to effect change in the hair's natural wave pattern. Finger waving provides the stylist the ability to learn how to control, push, pull, and manipulate the hair into the directions we choose for it to go, as opposed to just allowing the hair to behave how it naturally intends to. Finger waving lotion is a liquid gel that is traditionally made from Karaya gum. A proper finger waving lotion should not flake when it is dried. Let's perform finger waves. Begin with towel dried hair that is damp, but not dripping wet. Apply enough finger waving lotion to complete one side of the head. Begin at the front hairline. Using only 1 inch of the wide tooth side of your all-purpose styling comb and holding the comb in an upright or perpendicular position, comb the hair into a C shape. Hold the shape in place by laying your index finger across the center of the C and apply pressure to the hair against the scalp as you direct the hair into the circular pattern. Repeat this process directly behind the first C shape to create an elongated CC shape. Repeat this process working in 1 to 2 inch sections at a time, from the front hairline to the crown, creating a row of CCCCCCCCCCCCC shapes. To create the second row, we will begin on the closed side of the C shape, at the crown area. Keeping your finger in place across the center of the C shape, still using only 1 inch of the wide tooth side of your all-purpose styling comb, and holding the comb in an upright or perpendicular position, direct a 1-inch section of hair to the right. Without moving the comb away from the hair, lay the comb into a flattened position, with the teeth of the comb pointing upward, toward the top of the head. Still holding the hair in place against the scalp with your finger, push the teeth of the comb up under your finger. Gently pick up your index finger, and lay your middle finger in its place. Now using your index finger, gently squish the ridge of hair that was created by laying the comb down and pushing it up under your finger, in between your index and middle fingers, and hold it firmly in place against the scalp. Gently scrape the teeth of the comb against the scalp to rotate the comb back into a standing position while holding the newly formed ridge in place. Lay your thumb down behind the end of the comb and comb the hair into a backwards C shape around your thumb to create an S shape. Repeat this process directly behind the first backwards C shape to create an elongated SS shape. Repeat this process working in 1 to 2 inch sections at a time, working from the crown to the front hairline, creating a row of SS shapes. Repeat both rows as needed, alternating C patterns to create an S pattern. Pin curls serve as the basis for forming waves, curls, and rolls in wet hair styling. Pin curls create springy, long-lasting curls, with good direction and definition. Pin curls are made up of three principal parts: the base, the stem, and the circle. The base is the area of the hair on the scalp, where the hair for the curl is picked up. This is also the panel of hair, where the hair will be placed once the curl is complete. The stem is the area between the base and the first turn of the curl. The stem gives the curl direction and movement. The circle is the part of the curl that creates a complete circle, or multiple circles. It determines the width and strength of the wave or curl. As we just learned, the stem determines the direction and mobility of a curl. Curl mobility is defined by how much of the stem is exposed when placing the curl on its base section. The no-stem pin curl is one in which the circle portion of the curl is wound all the way down to the base section and has no stem showing. A no-stem pin curl produces a tight, firm, long-lasting curl and allows for little to no movement. A half-stem pin curl is one which the circle is wound to place the curl halfway on and halfway off of the base section. A half-stem pin curl provides good control to the hair. A full-stem pin curl is one where the circle is wound and positioned sitting completely off of or below the base section of the curl, and the full stem is exposed. A full-stem pin curl provides the most movement. If a full-stem pin curl is over-exaggerated or not wound up completely, then the hair will be flat and straight at the scalp and curly towards the ends. A shaping is the section of hair that is molded in preparation for curls. Finger waves are an example of a shaping. However, there are other types of shapings as well. Shapings will have an open end and a closed end. You should always begin pin curls at the open end of a shaping. Open center pin curls have an opening in the center of the curl, similar to a donut. Open center curls produce even, uniform, and smooth curls, meaning that curls created with an open center will have the same size of curl or wave pattern throughout the length of the hair strand. Closed center pin curls are completely closed in the center of the curl, similar to that of a cinnamon roll. Closed center curls have a smaller diameter at the ends of the hair, growing in size towards a larger diameter at the scalp. Clockwise and counterclockwise are the terms used to describe the direction of pin curls. Curls formed where the open end of the stem is directed in the same direction as the hands of a clock move is referred to as clockwise. Whereas, curls formed where the open end of the stem is directed in the opposite direction of the movement of the hands on a clock is termed counterclockwise. Pin curl bases are used to subdivide the hair into workable sections to create the type of curl your client desires. To avoid splits in a finished hairstyle, you must use careful consideration when selecting the type of base in which to use to form your pin curls. Where the curl is placed in relation to its base section determines how the curl will react. The shape of the base does not affect the finished curl. Rectangular base pin curls are recommended at the side, front hairline to create a smooth, upswept effect. Triangular base pin curls are recommended along the front or facial hairline to help prevent splits and breaks in the finished hairstyle. Arc base pin curls are those carved out of a shaping and lie flat against the scalp. Arc base pin curls are the most commonly used and give pin curls a good direction. Square base pin curls are suitable for curly hairstyles where little to no volume or lift is desired. Square base pin curls can be used on any area of the head, although staggered or bricklaid sections are recommended. Ribboning is the process of using your thumb to force a strand of hair against the backbone of the comb to create tension while pulling the hair through the comb from the scalp to the ends. Ribboning the hair is similar to curling ribbon with a pair of scissors. This technique is used to prepare the hair for pin curls. Carved curls are created by slicing a strand of hair out of a finger-waved shaping, without lifting it away from the shaping, and then forming it into a pin curl. Ridge curls are carved pin curls that are placed immediately behind, or below, a ridge. Skip waves are two rows of ridge curls, formed by skipping a ridge in between the rows of pin curls. Cascade curls are also known as stand-up pin curls. They are used to create height and are anchored in a standing position. The diameter of the curl determines the amount of height in the comb out. Barrel curls have the same effect as cascade curls. One barrel curl is equivalent to 2 to 4 cascade curls. Barrel curls create a curl effect similar to that of the roller, but will not have the same strength or lasting ability as roller curls, because a barrel curl is created with a lot less tension.